Now I want to overcast the edges of the dress with the green piping. The reason for that, there was a slight bit of a damage in the lace, and I could have left the lace, but because of that damage I needed to cover the edging off. So I decided to cover it in the bias coat binding. This is just a solution. If your edges are raw and unselvaged, if you're using fabric, then this is probably one of the methods that you could use to actually overlay the edges with. So I started at the center of the back because the joint, we don't mind the joint coming towards the center of the bag. And on reaching that center, I'm just going to fold it over and join the two rows. So I'm doing this. This is a bias coat binding that you get readily available. And what we're going to do is, what we're going to do is turn this over on the towards the top side. So having attached this, starting at the back, having attached this all the way around, I'm going to go back now and finish this off. So the back area can be a little bit fidgety where you start this off, but not to worry, it's at the back. You can actually be patient and do this, cut this down, but I'm being impatient and I'm just working around. Now we're turning this towards the outer side, and this should give you an even finish. Going all the way down. This will cover any unsalvaged edges, if you had unsalvaged edges, or if the lace is not as clean on the outer sides. Once you get to the point of the turning, lead the needle down and pivot the fabric around, creating an as neat corner as possible and working around. Now I've got a slight bit of a disadvantage. I've gone and placed my glasses somewhere and I can't actually focus in on this fully due to the fact that my vision has slightly deteriorated. Again, the point of the cord, neaten it off as much as possible and then work back upwards. That what that will do is finish off the neckline in the green ribbon type of a trim. And that's just another way of working with ribbons and trims.